When might you engage in paradoxical undressing?
So you're undressing, but you're actually dressing.
No, it's not really paradoxical.
Is it physics or something? Physics or mathematics?
No.
Is it counterintuitive undressing?
It's, that's much more what it is.
So taking your clothes off if Jeremy Clarkson asks you would be...
Meow.
Would be silly.
It's taking your clothes off when taking your clothes off looks like the worst possible idea you could have.
Is it some effect of hypothermia? Is it some mental thing that does to you?
It may be mental, it may be physical. It's not quite understood, but one of the...
Oh, that is very unpleasant.
Yeah.
Can we go back to the previous picture?
Yeah. Yeah, it's one of the peculiar side effects of hypothermia. When you're actually dying of cold,
you feel
one
hot.
Of the, almost the last thing you do, very commonly, not always, is take all your clothes off. And people think it may be a delusional thing, but it also is part of the fact that your blood vessels near your skin tend to just give up and open. And it may be that people feel very hot. Because you never survive once you've got to that stage, you can't actually ask someone why they did it. But it is a common thing for people to do, and they're freezing.
I went in freezing water once in New Zealand, and I screamed a lot and swam about a bit, and then I got out and I was completely shocking, livid pink, and felt hot. Well, so that was perhaps seconds from death, then.
Maybe you were. Maybe you're one of the few who survived it.
Yeah.
Well, what sort of temperature do you think would start you to on the road to hypothermia? Body temperature, I don't mean outside temperature.
What's the temperature in here?
I'd say pretty quickly. I think you'd have to drop much, maybe 4 or 5 degrees below normal body
temperature. That's right, 35 degrees Celsius, once your body temperature starts to get below that. And interestingly, in the coldest cities in the world, hypothermia is very rare. It's much more common in places like Britain, where it doesn't get very cold at all. There's a very remarkable Briton called Lewis Pugh. Have you heard of Lewis Pugh? He's a man who's able to control his own body temperature. He does endurance cold swimming. As far as we know, he's the only person known to science who can do what he can do. He can swim in cold conditions unlike anybody else, and he is able to raise his body temperature at will. It's completely startling.
He's
he can stop himself shivering. He can. He is really an incredible figure, and we contacted him. And he said that he thought he could do this...
So he's not coming in here because it's free. Yeah.
Yeah, he said he thought he could do this because he had trained himself, as it were, over years and years and years to do these endurance swims in incredibly cold waters. And then his body, as it were, saw it coming and prepared for it. That was his only explanation. But
cold water has a bad effect on a boy. I mean, he looks good there. I bet he doesn't fill his swimming trunks when he gets out.
Well, maybe that.